Let's say we wanted to determine how much light we were going to need in a space like this, assuming the space has never been built. We would use the Lumen method of calculation. The Lumen method is a process by which we can determine the average light level over an entire area, as long as we're talking about light coming from a uniform ceiling layout like the one we have overhead. Let's first measure in this particular space how much light we have. On this particular table, we see that we have 60 foot candles. On this one, we have, in fact, 57 foot candles. And on this one, we have 59 foot candles. Now, considering the amount of light that's coming from the windows, I will take that out. I'll take the average of these three, remove the 3 foot candles coming from daylight. And in fact, I see that we have about 56 foot candles in this room. Let's calculate how much we would expect to have. The Lumen method of calculation allows us to calculate the average illuminance over a given area. Illuminance, you might recall, is measured in foot candles, and the definition of a foot candle is the total lumens divided by the area of the space. In this case, we find the total lumens by taking the lamp lumens, multiplying times the number of lamps per luminaire times the number of luminaires in the space, and we divide it by the entire area. In this case, we have 2,600 lumens per lamp times 2, and with 16 luminaires, which is a total of 83,200 lumens. If we divide that by the area, 33 feet by 27 feet, which is 891 square feet, we in fact find 93 foot candles. In our cafeteria space, we've measured 55 foot candles, but with a quick calculation, we found that we expected 93 foot candles. How do we account for this difference? Well, to do that, we have to understand that our calculation was based on the initial lumens being produced in the luminaire. Those lumens have to be emitted from the luminaire, and they have to be delivered to the surface where we're trying to calculate. To account for these things, we talk about light loss factors. For fluorescent luminaires, we have lamp lumen depreciation as the most significant light loss factor, but also the effect of the ballast or the ballast factor and the ambient temperature the fluorescent lamps find themselves operating. If we were calculating for incandescent downlights, we'd have to account for voltage, so we'd have a voltage factor, or perhaps even lamp burnouts, because we would expect with short life lamps to have potential number of burnouts in any given area. With LED luminaires, we actually, initial lumens and emitted lumens from the luminaire are the same because we use absolute photometry, but we'd still have to account for lamp lumen depreciation, which for LEDs could be as much as 30% of light loss or 70% maintained lumens. But practice suggests that we go to about 40% of life, and therefore we'd consider 80 to 85% lamp lumen depreciation. Also, the difference between emitted lumens and delivered lumens on the surface, we have to account for the efficiency of the luminaire, the reflectances within the space, and its volume. And we use one factor to account for all three of those things, and that's called the coefficient of utilization. So in this example, we're using an existing space to actually describe light loss factors and the coefficient of utilization. But if this space had not been built, this Lumen method of calculation is a very powerful tool for determining how much light we would give from a certain installation, or simply manipulating the equation, figuring out how many luminaires we need in order to provide the target illuminance. So our revised equation then is that illuminance is equal to the total lumens times the light loss factor times the coefficient of utilization. These are both expressed as percentages divided by the area of the space, where the light loss factors include all the factors we mentioned before, lamp lumen depreciation, ballast factor being the big ones, and the coefficient of utilization, which considers the efficiency of the luminaire, the reflectances of the space, and the volume. By putting these numbers into the calculation and accessing them through tables, we actually use the Lumen method to calculate the average expected illuminance over a given area, a very powerful tool for lighting designers in determining how many luminaires, how to lay them out, and how to provide the proper illuminance in the space.